Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today I'm going to show you that how you can create this simple animated loader in PowerPoint 2016 with a bit motion blur. As you can see that both of these boxes has a little bit motion blur running along with both of the boxes. So let's get started. First of all, I will take a new presentation by clicking on the file menu, then click on new and then choose blank presentation. Click on the layout drop down button and choose blank. And if you need, then you can turn on the guides by clicking on the view menu, then click guides to enable the guides on the screen. Now I am going to insert a shape here. Go to the insert tab and then click shapes drop down button and choose rectangle for that. And just click inside the presentation and it will create a 1x1 size default rectangle, and we need a 2x2, so I am going to change the size from size section of the format tab. So after filling the size, hit the enter key. Now click on the align drop down button from the format tab and choose align center and align middle. And these vertical and horizontal guides is showing that this rectangle is in the middle of the slide. Now I am going to insert another rectangle here, and that will be 1x1 in size as you can see here, and just drag and drop it right over this rectangle and change the fill color so you can see both of these rectangle separately. And I need to make another rectangle here, and for that you can either use the copy or paste command, or you can hold down the control key and then drag it right here. Let me undo this. And while copying and pasting using the control key, you can also hold down the shift key along with the control key. That will copy the shape in the straight line. So I am going to place it right here. And when moving objects, if you hold down only the shift key, then the objects will move in a straight line. And that will be easier for you to manage the objects precisely. Now select all these three rectangles by selecting the first one, then hold down the shift key and then select rest of the objects on the slide. Go to the format tab, click on the group drop down button and choose group. Now right click on the shape and choose format shape. Go to the size and properties and expand the size drop down button. And here I am going to rotate this object to 315 degrees. And then close this format shape dialog box. And now we need to ungroup these objects. Click ungroup from the group drop down button. So we don't need any outline for these rectangles, so select all of these three rectangles. You can draw a rectangle like this to select all the objects within this area, or you can also press Ctrl A to select all the objects in the slide. Then go to the format tab and click shape outline drop down button and choose no outline. So before applying the animations to these two rectangles here, first of all I will go to the home tab and then click the select drop down button and open selection pan. And here I am going to apply the name of these rectangles. For example, that will be our rectangle 1 and that will be our rectangle 2. And for the background rectangle, you can name it background. However, we don't need it later on, so I will either hide it or delete it. So the next thing is to apply the animation, and I am going to use motion paths for that. Go to the animation tab, click add animation drop down button and then move to more motion paths. And here I am going to choose diagonal upright. However, you can choose any path and later you can modify the direction of the path. For instance, I am going to use diagonal upright and then adjust the path length, and I am going to drop it right here. And you can see these red guidelines which indicate that the object is precisely has been fit within that area of the rectangle. Now I am going to apply the next animation on the same rectangle, and that will be again the motion path, and this time I am going to use up motion path, or you can choose even choose down motion path, and later you can modify the directions. So the important thing is here that you first need to adjust the starting point of this second motion path, and that will be the ending point of the first one, and the ending point of the second motion path will be right here at this point. As you can see that this red guideline indicates that the motion path has been perfectly settled here. Now again I am going to apply the third motion path to the same object, and this time I am going to choose left and then adjust the starting point right here, and then the ending point, right here. Okay, now finally I am going to apply the fourth motion path, and that will be diagonal down right. Then adjust the starting point to the ending point of the third one, and then the ending point will be right here. When you see this red guideline, that means the direction is perfect. Okay, now open the animation pan, select all of these four animations by selecting the first one, then hold down the shift key and then select the last one, then set it to play with previous, and then adjust the duration to 0.25 seconds and then add a delay of 0.25 seconds between each animation. That will be 0.25 for the second, 0.50 for the third, and 0.75 for the fourth one. And now we no longer need that blue rectangle in the background. So either you can select that rectangle or hit the delete key, or you can also hide that rectangle from the selection menu. Just click the I button and that will hide this rectangle. Okay, now as I have told you in my previous tutorials that you can use Animation Painter to copy the same effects to another objects, but that is not going to help in this animation. Let me show you why. For instance, as I have selected the first rectangle and then I choose the Animation Painter and then click on the second rectangle, so that will change the path direction. However, you can select all of these four animations of the second rectangle by selecting the first one, then hold down the shift key, then select on the second one, third one, and the fourth one, and then drag and drop these animation right over here. Okay, but that is not going to help, because when I will see the slideshow, both of the rectangle will start moving from the same direction. So you will only see one rectangle in a time. So that is why we can't use Animation Painter in this animation. So we need to apply the same animation to the second rectangle from the beginning. So go to the more motion path and then start applying the animations. For instance, the first one will start from right here and will end right here. For the time, I will turn on the background rectangle and later I will hide it again. So the first path will be right here. Let me zoom in and then again go to the add motion paths and apply another motion path and adjust the starting and ending position. The starting position will be right here and the ending position will be right here. Okay, now the third motion path, and this time I will use right, set it right here, and the ending point will be right here. And finally the last one, add more motion paths, and this time I will use, you can use any motion path and later configure the path setting. The starting point will be right here, and the ending point will be in the beginning. When you see the red guideline, that means the path has fit properly. It is a bit hard in PowerPoint to adjust the motion path length. Now select all of these four animations and set them to play with previous. Adjust the duration of the animations and add a delay timing. And then adjust the delay timing and I will start everything from the zero and later add the delay timing to the second one, then the third one and the fourth one. Okay, let's see the preview. Okay, that's fine. So now I am going to hide the background rectangle. And for motion blur, what you can do, you can copy this, the first rectangle here, copy and paste, and then change the color. Go to the shape fill, more fill color, and then lighten the color. Hit the OK button and send it to the back. Then adjust the rectangle right over on top of the previous one. The last thing you need to do is to add the delay timing. And this time I will add a delay timing of 0.10 second for the first animation of the background rectangle that will behave like a motion blur. And then we'll start adding an extra 0.10 seconds in the delay timing, and that will be 0.35 seconds for the second one, 0.60 for the third one, and 0.85 for the last one. Let's see the preview. So the motion blur will totally depend on the delay timing. So I think I need to reduce the delay timing to 0.05 and 0.30 for the second one, 0.55 for the third one, and finally 80 for the last one. Now let's see the preview. Okay, that's fine. And you need to do the same for the second rectangle. And what you can do, you can select it, the second rectangle, and hit copy and paste, then change the color. So instead of clicking on the shape fill drop down button, if you just click right here, then it will fill the last color that you have chosen in the previous steps. So just click it right here and then send it to back and adjust the position. Okay, that's perfect. And then add the delay timing. And here I am going to apply the same delay timing as I did for the previous motion blur. And finally apply a background by right clicking on the empty area of the slide, choose format background and apply a fill color that you like. I am going with the black color. And then you can add your text. Go to the insert tab, choose word art and choose any style you want. Change the fill color of the text and type the text you need to show in the slideshow. Live stream will start soon. You can format it as you want. So I will go with DK Jumbo, and then you can add an animation to the text, and I will go with the wave. Set it to play with previous with the duration of 0.25 seconds and set the delay timing to 0. And you can also apply another animation to the text, and that could be font color if you want to, and set it to play with previous with the 0 delay timing and a short duration of 0.25 seconds. Now let's see the slideshow. And you need to increase the length of the video that will you later you will export from the PowerPoint. Then what you can do, you can make duplicates of this slide by right clicking on the thumbnail view of the slide. And if you are not seeing the thumbnail view, that means it has been collapsed here. You can either click on this arrow or you can expand it right from here. Then right click on the slide and choose duplicate slide. Duplicate slide as many times you want, equal to the length of the animation that you want. I will go with 5 slides. Now select the first one and then select the last one by holding the shift key, and then note down what is the maximum length of the animations, and I think that will end on 1.1 second. So in the transition tab, uncheck on mouse click and make a check mark on after and apply the same duration as of the animation. So I will go with 1.2 10 seconds. Now let's see the slideshow. And here we have our final animation. The color of the objects totally depends on you. One more thing before I end the tutorial, and that is, if you want to loop the single slide, then you can delete the rest one and then go to the slideshow, click setup slideshow and make a check mark on loop until escape. And that way the presentation will continue to run until you will press the escape key. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments. And if you find this video informative and interesting, then you can hit the like button and can share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.